My name is Josh Ritter. I'm a songwriter from Moscow, Idaho.
He opens his eyes, falls in love at first sight with the girl in the doorway. What beautiful lines, how full of life after thousands of years. What a face to wake up to. He holds back a sigh, she touches his arm. She dusts off the bed where till now he's been sleeping under miles of stone. The dried fig of his heart under scarab and bone starts back to its beating.
One of the primary rules I make for myself is never to write autobiographically, you know? I feel that there's enough of that in the world. I mean, when I was writing a song called The Curse on my new record, you know, I woke up with this story in my head, a kind of a love affair between a mummy and an archaeologist.
In New York, he is laid in a glass-covered case. He pretends he is dead. People crowd round to see him, but each night she comes round, and the two wander down halls of the tomb that she calls a museum.
And I just knew I had to get up. It had been months since I'd been able to write a song. I just knew I had to get up and write it down. So I went into the bathroom, I sat on the bathtub, and I wrote down everything I knew about mummies and everywhere I thought the story could go. And I wrote and wrote, and then I went to bed, and the next week or so I made this song. I made The Curse.
He walks outside to find her. She's using a cane, and her face looks too pale. She's happy to see him. As they walk, he supports her. She asks, are you cursed? But his answer's obscured in a sandstorm of flashbulbs and rowdy reporters. Oh.
The name of my record is So Runs the World Away. It's a line from Hamlet. And the line is, some must watch while some must sleep, so runs the world away. And I love that. And I mean, I like the idea of a play. The album felt like a play. I always, you know, Hamlet's obviously so much like all of us, you know, in a lot of ways. Very mercurial and confused.
I am assured, yes, I am assured that peace will come to me. A peace that can, yes, surpass the speed, yes, of my understanding and my need.
And I've always loved people like Flannery O'Connor, Muriel Spark, or Philip Roth, or Stephen King, or you know, people that let bad stuff happen to their characters. Because I think that if you're going to make a song a story, something has to happen. And sometimes, you know, most of the time, something bad has to happen.
And I was thinking about my river days. And I was thinking about me and Jim. Passing Cairo, wanna get away. With every steamboat like a hymn. Out on the desert now and I'm feeling lost. The bunhead wears a wire albatross. There's monster ballads in the stations of the cross. Sighing just a little bit.
Literature is the larger influence in, on me just because I just think it has to be. I mean, I think I love writing. I love words, you know, and I love writing songs. But to me, without the words, without something, I have too little to grab hold of, you know.
I'm thinking about what Katie did, the fairest daughter of the Pharaoh's son. She's dressed in gold in these pyramids. Out on the desert now, and I'm feeling.
There's a magical moment when a word will lock up with a melody, and where the word comes from, whether you woke with the phrase in your head, or whether you heard it down the bar, whether you, however it came to you, there is a phrase that locks up with a melody, and it's indescribable. There's no theory or practice to it, and I really wouldn't believe anybody who said there was.
Light of my lantern.
You you know, I always thought that first of all I was a writer, I was and a musician second, you know, and a writer's job is to tell a story, you know, and in whatever style they choose.